Hello everyone, next we are going to see the topic called transmission media. So this is a transmission media which is located below the physical layer and it is controlled by the physical layer. So when a message has to be transmitted from the sender to the receiver, and this is the physical layer, and this is the physical layer of the receiver. When a message has to be transmitted from the sender to receiver, it has to be from the physical layer, it has to be sent to the transmission media. Through the transmission media, the message will be sent and it will be given to the physical layer in the receiver side. So this is the transmission media. This transmission media, it can be wired or it can be wireless. If it is a wired one, we will be using a cable, and if it is a wireless one, we will be transmitting through air. Okay, so we can define the transmission media as, transmission media can be defined as anything that can carry information from source to destination. Destination is called as transmission media. So it can be a media which carries information from source to destination, that is called transmission media. Next we will see the classes of transmission media. Okay, so transmission media is broadly classified into two types. One is guided media and other one is unguided media. Okay, so guided media is again classified into twisted pair, coaxial cable and fiber optic cable. So unguided media, it is a free space. Okay, so this is classified into radio wave, microwave and infrared wave. So this guided media is a wired one and unguided media is the wireless media. So here when we are transmitting the signal, it will be transmitted through the cable. So when it is transmitted through, the types of transmission media are guided one and unguided one. In the guided media, it is wired one, it is again classified into, we can use a twisted pair to send the information, or we can use coaxial cable, or we can use fiber optic cable. Coming to unguided media, it will be transmitted through free space. So we can use radio wave, microwave or infrared wave for transmission. Now we will see in detail about guided media. So guided media, it is or those that provide contact from one device to another device. So guided media are those that provide a contact from one device to another device. Through a cable. So it is broadly classified into twisted pair cable, coaxial cable and fiber optic cable. So first we will see in detail about twisted pair cable. Coming to twisted pair cable, it consists of two insulated copper wires. So it is arranged in a spiral pattern. So this is a one wire. One more wire. So this is your twisted pair cable. It consists of two insulated, it is made up of copper wires. It is arranged in a spiral pattern and twisted together. So this is the twisted pair cable. So here one of the cable will send the signal, one of the wire will send the signal, and other wire will act as the ground reference. So there are two types of twisted pair cable. One is shielded twisted pair, or in short we can write STP. Other one is unshielded twisted pair. In short we can write UTP. So in coming to shielded twisted pair, there will be a cover to protect the twisted pair. So IBM has introduced this twisted pair cable, and by the name itself you can say it will have a cover to shield the copper wires. But coming to unshielded twisted pair, here we will not be having any cover to protect the cables. So this is all about your shielded twisted pair and unshielded twisted pair. Now we will see the difference between unshielded twisted pair cable and shielded twisted pair cable. So coming to unshielded twisted pair cable, so here there will be a plastic cover. Okay, so this is shielded twisted pair cable, and after which you have a metal shield, or you can say that it is a braided mesh. It is a mesh. So from here, insulated copper wire will be there. So this is the plastic cover, and this is the metal shield. So in shielded twisted pair cable, there will be a metal shield which is covering this copper wire. So this mesh shield will be braided, and it will be a mesh in, it will be in mesh format, and after which it is encased by a plastic cover. This is a shielded twisted pair cable. Coming to unshielded twisted pair cable, there will be a plastic cover, and after which you have your insulated wires. So there is no shield for covering your insulated wires. So this is your unshielded twisted pair cable. So in coming to this shielded twisted pair cable, because of this metal shield, it will prevent the noise that is, or crosstalk that occurs inside the cable, and it is more expensive and bulkier also. When we compare this UTP cable with this STP cable, it is more expensive and it is, the cable looks bulkier. This is all about your STP and UTP. Now we will see the performance of twisted pair. So coming to the performance of twisted pair, so here we are going to compare the frequency with attenuation. Now in this performance, so we are going to compare the frequency with attenuation. So attenuation is the loss of energy occurs when a signal is passed through the transmission medium. So it is measured in decibel meter by decibel by kilometer. and this is in kilohertz. Frequency is measured in kilohertz. So it is 10, 100 kilohertz and 1000 kilohertz. So when it is, this is attenuation will be 2, 4, 6, 8. So here, this is what the curve we will get when it is passed to the transmission medium. So here we are going to compare with for four cables. One is 18 gauge cable, other one is 22 gauge cable, and the third one is 24 gauge, and the last one is 26 gauge cable. So here the gauge is nothing but it is the thickness of the wire. So this is what the performance we will get. So here at 100 kilohertz, this attenuation, it sharply increases. It sharply increases above 100 kilohertz. So this is what the performance of twisted pair cable. Now we will see the applications of twisted pair cable. Coming to the applications of twisted pair cable. So first application is, it is used in telephone lines to provide both voice and data. So in some cases, for example, if you are going to connect the subscribers with the main central telephone office, in that case, what we can do is we can use an UTP twisted pair, unshielded twisted pair, for connecting the subscribers with central telephone office. Okay, these are all the applications. These are all the applications of twisted pair cable. Now we will see the advantages. So coming to the advantages, it is very simple. Okay, the second one is, it is flexible, and third is, it is easy to install, and fourth is, it is cheaper. Okay, and fifth one is, it is low weight. So these are all the advantages of twisted pair cable. Coming to the disadvantages. Disadvantages, it is having high attenuation. So there will be, the loss of the signal will be more when we are going to use twisted pair cable. So in this, we have seen on twisted pair cable. So here we have, in the twisted pair cable, there will be an insulated two copper wires. It will be arranged in spiral pattern. It is of two types. One is unshielded twisted pair cable, other one is shielded twisted pair cable. In case of shielded twisted pair cable, there will be a braided mesh which is covering the two copper wires. And in case of unshielded twisted pair, there will not be any cover will be there. Coming to performance of the network, we have seen the performance comparing the frequency and the attenuation, and we've seen the graph and application. It can be used in telephone line to provide voice and data, and these are the advantages and disadvantages of your twisted pair cable. Now we will see the next topic in this guided media, that is coaxial cable. So coaxial cable, it is mainly used in cable TV, or it is used in high-speed LAN, or it is used in telephone wires. Okay, so here there will be an inner conductor. Coaxial cable, there will be an inner conductor which is surrounded by an insulator like this. This is an inner conductor which is surrounded by an insulator which is again enclosed by an outer conductor. This is an outer conductor. This is in the mesh format, braided mesh format. And again, it is enclosed by an insulator. which in turn it is covered by a plastic cover. So this is the structure of the coaxial cable. So the coaxial cable will have an interconductor which is in turn surrounded by an insulator, inner insulator, and again it is enclosed by an outer conductor which is braided mesh, which in turn it is enclosed by an outer insulator which is again covered by a plastic cover. So this shield, this metallic wrapping or this braided mesh will protect from noise and as well as other interferences. Okay, so this is the structure of the coaxial cable. So this coaxial cable, coming to the advantages of coaxial cable, it is much better since saturation is less compared to twisted pair cable. It is much better than twisted pair. The second is, it is used for broadband transmission and it works for higher bandwidth too. It works for higher bandwidth also. Coming to the disadvantages, one is, it is expensive when compared with twisted pair. It is very expensive. So here this coaxial cable, it is mainly used in cable TV, high speed or telephone wires, and it is having an inner conductor which in turn it is surrounded by an insulator, which in turn it is enclosed by an outer conductor which is covered by insulator and plastic cover. So the wire, the signals it is transmitted through this particular transmission medium will be very safe and it is very secure. That is why in most high speed transmission you will be using this type of coaxial cable. And these are the advantages and disadvantages of coaxial cable. Now we will see the last cable in guided media, that is fiber optic cable. So fiber optic cable, it is used for communicating in longer distances and it is used in private companies where high speed communication is required, and it is also used in cable TV communication where they will be using both the type of network, optical fiber cable and as well as coaxial cable for communication. So these type of combination of networks is called as hybrid network, where optical fibers will be used in the act as a backbone for the network and coaxial cable will be connected to all the user premises. So this cable TV, when they are going to use a combination of these two types of cables, then they will get the user, it will be cost effective and also they will get high bandwidth. That is why they are using a combination of these two. So now before going in detail about fiber optic, we will see the aspects of light. When a light travels in the same medium, that is in the same medium, it always travels in the straight line. But when the light travels from one medium to another medium, there will be the ray of light will get reflected or refracted based on the density of the medium. So here we are going to see how the light, ray of light, it gets reflected or refracted because of change in the density of the medium. So here when the ray of light, when it passes from the more density medium to the less density medium, so what happens is that the ray of light is lesser than the critical angle, the ray of light will get refracted from the interface. So here in this second diagram, so here what happens is that when the ray of light, if it is equal to the critical angle, so ray of light will, instead of going refraction, it will coincide with the surface of the medium interface. That is more, it will be coinciding with the medium. And the third diagram, so here when the ray of light, if it is greater than the critical angle, instead of getting refracted, it gets reflected inside the medium. So here optical fiber, it chooses this third property, that is it gets when it is traveled through a medium, high more density medium to less density medium, this ray of light will get reflected and it comes inside the medium itself. So now we will see how optical fiber, the structure of optical fibers. So coming to the structure of optical fiber, it is made up of a, it is having a core. This cable, it will be connected, it will be enclosed with a glass or plastic. Again, this glass or plastic is enclosed with plastic cover. So this is a structure of optical fiber. So a copper wire will be enclosed with glass or plastic, and again which is again enclosed with plastic cover. So this is the structure of optical fiber. So we can also draw like this. So this is the, we can call this glass or plastic to be cladding, and there will be an outer cover over here. So inside this there is a conductor. Here the signals will be passed. Suppose for example the sender is sending a message. So when it has been sent, since it is this glass or medium is different medium and here it is having a different medium, so what happens is that it gets reflected and it goes, the ray of light will goes inside this, and again it gets reflected inside the core, and at last it reaches the end of this cladding, it comes outside, and thus the receiver will receive the message. So here when the sender sends a message, so here the ray of light, since it is passing from more density to lesser density medium, it gets reflected again back, it gets reflected, and at last it reaches the end of the wire. Now the receiver will receive the message. This is how the optical fiber will send the message inside the medium. We will see the propagation modes of optical fiber. So propagation modes are divided into multimode and single mode. And again, this multimode is divided into step index and graded index. So what is multimode transmission is, here this optical channel will allow multiple beams of light to pass through the channel, that is multimode. And single mode is, it will allow only one beam of light to pass through the medium, that is single mode. So we will see the diagrams for multimode step index, multimode graded index, and last is single mode. Coming to multimode step index, this is the core of the of the transmission medium, and outside we have a cladding, and outside we have the plastic cover. So here when the source sends the message inside this transmission medium, several beams of light will be passed inside this medium, it gets reflected and it reaches the edge of this core. Here the density of this core will be constant from the center to the edges. So when once if it reaches the edges, here it has to move to the next outside cable where it is having lesser medium. So here what happens is the distortion occurs only at the edges. This is what the output we will get at the destination. Now coming to multimode graded index method, here also the source will send the message, here multiple beams will travel through this density, through this core. Here what happens is that the density of the core will be highest at the center and it will be lower at the edges of this core. So once this ray of light, it passes, it goes to the edges of the core, outside medium is also lower and here also it is having a lesser medium. So what happens is distortion will be less at the edges. This is what we have got at the receiver. Now we move on to the single mode transmission. In single mode, only one beam of light will be passed inside the core. So the radius of the core will be less when compared to other two methods. So it passes and it reaches the end, and this is what the output we will get at the destination. So in this topic we have seen several propagation modes, multimode, single mode, and we have seen in detail about step index and graded index with the neat diagram. Now we will see the advantages of optical fiber. The first advantage is higher bandwidth. So this fiber optic cable support higher bandwidth than the coaxial cable and twisted pair. Second is less signal attenuation. Usually this optical fiber can travel longer distance. Even though it is traveling in longer distance, it will have less attenuation. Suppose if you are going to use fiber optic other twisted pair or coaxial cable for 50 kilometers, suppose you have to run a signal inside run a signal for 50 kilometer, so in that case for every 5 kilometer you need to have a repeaters for coaxial cable or this twisted pair. But here you need not have this type of repeaters. So what happens is attenuation will be very less. Third one is immunity to electromagnetic interference. Electromagnetic waves will not affect any noise to optical fiber. And fourth is resistance to corrosive materials. Since glass or plastic is used outside this core, it is very resistant to corrosive materials than copper wires. Next is light weight. So this is very having a less weight when compared with other cables. And sixth one is it is more immune to tapping. Next, coming to the disadvantages, installation and maintenance will be high. So we require an expertise to install and maintain this type of cables. And the next is the second one is the cost. The cost involved in establishing the cable and interfaces will be more when compared to other cables. And third one is unidirectional light propagation. Usually the propagation of the light is unidirectional. It can able to pass in only one direction. Suppose if you want a bidirectional method, then you have to use two fibers. So these are all the advantages and disadvantages of fiber optic cable.